Welcome to the Believer's Walk of Faith, empowering believers through teaching, preaching, and demonstration of the uncompromised Word of God to fulfill their highest calling and change this world through Jesus Christ, to glorify God in all we do, to train up and send out believers, to cover the whole earth with the knowledge of the Lord. Welcome to the Believer's Walk of Faith.
Hello, this is Bill Winston, and welcome to another program. The program that you're watching is called The Believer's Walk of Faith, where we walk by faith and not by sight. We have an exciting program for you today. I'm telling you, get your Bible ready. We're talking about vengeance and recompense. Now, like I said, a lot of people don't know what vengeance means according to the biblical definition. It doesn't have to do with God mad at somebody, getting even with somebody. No. It has to do with love of justice. People that have been mistreated, God is about to move in on their behalf, the people of God. And also recompense. Recompense has to do with payback, or let's say somebody's done something against you or whatever have you, defrauded you. Well, they're about to pay it back. God is going to get it back for you. Now, He's not mad at people. Who He's coming against is the enemy, the devil, Satan himself. He stockpiled it all. God is going to take it, and He's going to transfer it into the hands of His people. Now, one thing about it is one day the children of Israel were in bondage. Here they were in slavery in Egypt. And then the next day they were coming through the Red Sea loaded. They had silver, they had gold, they had clothing. I'm just saying when Pharaoh came after them, notice the Red Sea swallowed them up. What am I telling you? I'm telling you that your financial condition of lack can be ended in one day. That's what's about to happen, folks. All you got to do is believe this. Praise the Lord. It's right in the Word of God. And then the next thing that happened is they shall build. This idea about building up something and having something to be built. Jesus never built a single school. He never built a single business. Why? That wasn't his calling. He wasn't supposed to build. We're supposed to do that. So we're going to take this overflow that He's going to give us, that's going to come into the body of Christ, and we shall build orphanages. We shall build business. I'm talking about godly businesses. We shall build seniors' homes. I'm talking about these are the things that are needed in the earth so that we can preserve humanity. It's a powerful teaching. Get your Bibles and pencils and paper ready. Let's go into it. It's called Vengeance and Recompense.
We have been struggling to try to get somewhere, but your struggle is over. The only reason we've been struggling is because we've been trying to operate off the wrong platform. Say amen to that.
Amen.
And then one group think they know more than the other. And that's all right, but don't cut everybody else out.
Yes. Amen. Yes, sir.
And then I go places now, I preach, and they don't even have a baptism pool. And don't even mention it. But in the platform, the moment they believed, they were baptized. In the platform, now in the platform, I'm talking about your denomination. I'm not talking about who taught you something else. I'm talking about come back to the platform.
That's it.
And biblical pattern yields biblical power. And you're supposed to be able to see a drug addict come into the house of God. This is supposed to be the tabernacle in the wilderness for people. This is supposed to be the spiritual powerhouse of God. That if you come in here with anything, that's the idea about the man who was sitting at the pool for 38 years. And every time he seemed to get up and go, somebody jumped in front of him. Jesus said, "Would you like to be made whole?" And he said, "Well, anybody that gets up there when the angels stir up the pool, whatever disease they have, they're going to be healed when they hit the pool. But they got to be the first one." Sound like the lottery, don't it? And so what happened? He said, "Listen, you don't need, I'm going to put in my own word, you don't need to wait on no pool. Rise. Take up your bed right now get up out of here. It doesn't make any difference what you got. You bring somebody in the house of God. Is any among you sick? Let him call for the elders of the church. Let him anoint him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save the sick. And the Lord will raise him up. And if there have been any sins, he'll be wiped out. He'll be forgiven. It didn't say, let him anoint him with oil, and we sure hope he gets healed. And people think getting healed of a headache. Headache? No, if any of you is missing a kidney, if any of you have had a stent put in your arteries, if any of you, come on now, let him call for the elders of the church, because healing a headache and putting in a kidney is all the same in the kingdom of God, man. There ain't no difference. The power of God is the power of God.
The idea about Ephesians is that when he tells you how far up you are, he is saying that you not only have authority, but you have a heritage of protection. Are y'all, somebody flowing with me here? And that goes along with Colossians 1, but let me just read this verse. Verse 21, far above. Come on, somebody say far above. All what? Principality and power and might and dominion and every name that's named. You say, well, that's Jesus. Verse 6 of chapter 2. And has raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. In other words, sit down. See, that heritage of protection says that every kind of attack or accident cannot reach you. Are you following what I'm saying? That you don't need to look back of you all the time, see if anybody's chasing you or whatever have you. No. Can't touch you. In other words, wizards and witches' curses can't touch you. They can't bother you. Turn on over to Colossians chapter 1. You need to see this, see? Now, wait a minute. Does it work if you don't believe it? No, it does not. There's nothing in here that's automatic. You got to believe this stuff. But it's got to be preached. This is part of the kingdom of God. In the kingdom of God, you have a heavenly immunity. Look what it says here in verse 12. Give verse chapter 1, verse 12. Giving thanks unto the Father, which has made us what? Meet or able to be partakers of the what? Inheritance of the what? Saints where? In light. I told you light came through Adam. Who has delivered us from what? Power of darkness. Who has delivered us from what? Who has delivered us from what? Did it say you're going to be delivered? Nope. It says what? You have been delivered. You already been delivered. Look at Luke. Come on back over here to Luke. Luke chapter 10, please. He said in verse 17, the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject to us through your name. And he said unto them, I beheld who? Satan as lightning fall from where? Heaven. Behold, I give unto you what? Power. To tread on what? Serpents. Keep going. And all the power of the enemy, come on, and nothing.
I said, I'm giving you power over all the power of the enemy. It doesn't make any difference what kind of power he's trying to use. I'm going to give you power in this last day on another level. This is not power that has been seen on the earth before. Folks, we're about to see a power that has never been seen and never been manifested in the earth. God has reserved that power for the last day. That power is here right now. I'm telling you, all we need to do is preach it and believe it and act on it. And we're going to see something that we ain't never seen before. You're going to see the power of God move in a church service, and everybody from one end of the building to the other end, all the way down to the nursery, is going to be healed of whatsoever disease they have, because this is a day of God's power. This is the day of the vengeance of the Lord. Boy, y'all got me preaching today. I hope y'all can keep up with this. Sit down. Let me finish this. It's time for payback. See, we're going to make the devil let you go. But God wants you to claim damages. Come on now. Don't look at me like that. You know you got some stuff due. If it ain't nothing but child support, you got something due. Now, this is not coming against people, because people, for the most part, were like Jesus said on the cross, Father, forgive them. Come on. For they know not what they do. I told you, no natural man can defeat those spirits. So those spirits get in their lives, get in their mind, and control them, and make them won't pay you or whatever have you and so forth. So you can't blame people. Let's go up to the root cause of this thing. And the root cause of this thing is the devil himself. And we're going into his den, and he's got hidden riches all over this world, and we're going to make him cough it up. We're going to come into every treasury that he has hidden money. I'm telling you, some bank accounts, some private bank accounts are about to be emptied. God is about to send angels in places. Now, I'm not trying to take nobody's money. I'm trying to get what belongs to me. That's all I want. Are y'all with me? I'm talking about we gonna demand some things. God says in Isaiah 45, he said, command ye me. That means commission him. That means allow him to do what he wants to do. And he said, vengeance is mine, saith the Lord, and I will recompense. Say amen to that. And recompense means to pay back. It means whatever's owed you, that it's got to be paid and got to be paid to you, because it's something that belongs to you. But I don't want just what belongs to me. I want what belongs to my granddaddy. I want what belongs to everybody that's in my family that the enemy has snatched something from. Now, understand, it's not a hate thing. It's not something that you don't love people. Say amen. I'm making the devil pay it back. It's God that's going to the devil and making him surrender everything that belongs to you. He's going to surrender your mind and give you peace. Say amen to that. Now, not only that, saints of God, we're going to demand some contracts. You see, there have been spiritual forces in the heavenlies, and they have been diverting contracts that were supposed to go to you. They have even been trying to pervert inventions and new ideas, that they tried to confuse your dream when God wanted to give you a dream. I'm saying there have been things that have been stolen from you that you don't even know nothing about. Well, I got news for you. Heaven kept track of it. Heaven kept track of everything that was yours, even back. Oh, Lord, have mercy. All I want is what's mine. That's all I want. I don't want what's yours. You can keep what's yours. Satan got to give me what's mine. See, you must must get this, because if you're immature, you'll miss this. This is not a hate message. This is a message where we're transferring the wealth of the sinner into the hand of God's people. Now, why are we doing that? For one reason, so that we can build the kingdom of God. That's the one reason why it's got to come in. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Sit down. Are y'all with me?
Yes.
No. The body of Christ is one. There's no schism anymore. We're brothers and sisters in here. But Satan has been resisting us. He's been resisting us and in ways that we don't even know about. So I command every contract from now on, every contract that's been stolen, every business opportunity that has been diverted. Lord, I'm preaching right now. I'm talking about everything that belongs to you, that belongs to your relatives, those who wanted to get this and bless it into your life. I'm commanding those things to be released now. I said restore. I said restore. I said restore. Every time you are off from work and the devil made you sick, I said restore. Even times that you were off from work and it was your own fault, I'm gonna plead the blood of Jesus and command that to come back as well. This is our time. I said this is our time. It took almost 7 years for us to get that bank started. That enemy resisted us right and left, one thing after another. And the time that we were to raise the money, it ran out, so our permit ran out. We had to go back to the feds to get another. And pretty soon, they said, listen, we have given you this several times. We're not going to give you anymore. If you can't raise the money, you just can't raise it. I had to go to the Lord. I said, Lord, something's wrong here. You see, without vengeance, some of this couldn't happen. I just want you to see it. Without vengeance, the children of Israel couldn't have gotten out of Egypt. Without vengeance doesn't have to do with hate, it has to do with justice. Say amen to this. Boy, God had to come in himself. And that is the only way we got it done. I'm telling you. He resisted us right up until the time that we were at the table writing a check. That ain't nothing but the devil, folks. We're writing a check for a few $1 million and they didn't have any money. You want to sit back and say, are you crazy? No, but you don't do that because you know it's the devil.
Yeah, it is.
Father, forgive them. Come on. For they don't know what they're doing. They're being used. But we know what we're doing. We're going to build the kingdom of God all over the world. So here's a time that Abimelech and Abraham came down there with Sarah, and he told her again, he said to the king, Abimelech, he said, listen, tell him now that you're my sister. Why? Because he didn't understand divine positioning. That if you're ever sent by God, you're protected by God. I don't care who you are. I don't care how rough it is you going into that place. Go right on in that neighborhood. Can't no gun shoot you. Folks, we still got pictures, I believe, of my wife and I. We're out there in the communities in Tulsa, and they got them gangs out there that's shooting, and they still got pictures of us making all the gangs hold hands while we pray. I think she still got pictures of them. You know why? We were sent.
Yeah.
And when you're sent, there is no fear in you. Come on now, help me now. There is no fear. Who is that? One of our members, Sister Bo Reese and them. They went out there, and she and another lady went, and they were witnessing. We were sent on Saturday. You're being sent on Saturday. And they went out there and witnessed and saw the guy coming across the street, and he was a gang leader, and saw him come across the street, well known. If I said the name of the gang, you'd know it here. And come across the street, and as he came across, they stopped and said, "Hey, excuse me, we'd like to talk to you about Jesus." He said, "Oh, all right, ladies, how y'all doing?" You know, kind of, you know, playing with them a little bit. And they said, "Well, listen, just shake our hand." He grabbed the hand to shake it. The power of God went through him. He fell out. Was on the sidewalk. All of a sudden, Mercedes pulled up from everywhere. His bodyguards pulled up. "What'd y'all do? What did you do with him? Put the hand on the gun. What'd you do with him?" Now, these are two ladies. "We didn't do anything." You follow what I'm saying? If it had been two men, it probably shot from across the street, if they weren't sent. But my point to you is, he got up. He said, "What happened to me?" He said, "You have been arrested by the Holy Ghost." Now, you're about to see power that you have never seen before, and it's going to come through you.